golden into the new years, guys. Golden. We're shining in the sun. Feed my soul. Merry Christmas, beautiful people from the sunny island of Curacao. I am currently two vlogs behind on my YouTube channel. Today is Tweede Kerstdag, or Boxing Day in English, Second Christmas Day if you translate to English, but on the islands we say Boxing Day. Look at these ridiculous nails. I got them done for my birthday before coming down, and now they are terrible. And as you can hear, I am sick again. Low immune system. All the stress, all the busyness from the last few weeks has just been having me very, very sick. But I thought, let me start a new vlog here. I need to upload two vlogs, as I mentioned. Oh, edit and upload two vlogs, my birthday and Bonaire trip to my YouTube channel. And this one has to also go out before the year. No, not before the year ends. It's not feasible. But yeah, bong simang. I just took some Viro grip. And I have here water and nose spray. This has been helping me so much lately. Oh, the first time when I was sick, and also now. Oh, there's an ant on my finger. Happy Christmas. Yesterday did not feel like a happy Christmas. It didn't start as a happy Christmas, so I did not vlog or start a vlog or do anything. And yeah, not every day is as vibrant as we want it to be vibrant, and that's allowed. But today feels a lot better, and I'm currently waiting for my sister to come back so we can leave to go to the beach at Yantil. And here they are, fashionably late, coming through. Beep beep. Say hi to the vlog.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm Shresker.
Shresker.
What is your name again? Candito? Hi, Candito. Hey. 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 I would like to get to know if I could be the kind of girl that you could be down for. Cause when I look at you, I feel something tell me that you're the kind of girl. What's your name?
Kaylin.
Aye. Kaylin, let's see.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I love it.
You love it.
Thank you, Sue-Jeen. It's closer. Need closer.
You need closer.
Nice dress.
It's a pretty dress.
I love it.
Yeah?
Jamaicans.
Are you Jamaican?
Let me show you what I got for Christmas.
What is that?
A pen. A quill pen. Mm-hmm. I got next earrings.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Peace.
I was going to do the same time.
We gaan naar broederliefde. Broederliefde with the sister. Let's go to broederliefde. I wanted to show you my makeup, but there's cars parking next to us. But anyway, we gaan naar broederliefde and Rick Ross in Curacao. Anyone that saw the, how do you say that? The ad from Rick Ross, he called Curacao Curacao. Dus we gaan naar Curacao. Concert with Rick Ross. And people, we're just leaving the party. My shoe break, net net. Ay, Dios mío. Ay. Oh, ay. Hi. Mommy not getting these shoes no more.
The most beautiful sunset that I came to get, but it's almost gone already. Oh well, look at this literal paradise. Everyone was coming. Oh, my hair. Chasing the sun, but yeah, it's gone now, but it's okay. Thank you.
a solo adventure. A morning at Pirate Bay, Curacao. Today's word is a word. It says, the hard work is done. Now you have reached your reward. Now it's time to learn joy. Yes, we are learning joy. The joy of embracing where we currently are and taking time out to detach and be full. Just finished my mango smoothie. And I don't know if you can see inside of it, but I tied the top of the cherry. What a mouth do. I decided to come to this beach because I thought, it'll be quiet, it'll be not so busy. First thing I came in and they told me, it's fully packed. Really? Like really? Like really? I wanted some peace and quiet. But all I hear now is Dutch. Is it in the half? On the tram, on the train, just in work. And it's okay, but I wanted some quiet time so I can journal, pull a card for myself, read my book, you know, do all my dingetjes, maar goed. I'm gonna do my dingetjes still, but just in a different way. Now writing a little, let me show you this super cute thing that the neighbors, let me cover what I wrote on my typewriter, what the neighbor's daughter wrote for me. I find it so cute. I was talking to a friend of mine about it and I realized that her doing this is just showing me a lot about my inner child and makes me feel so happy. She's only 9 years old and she wrote this. She's also from Curacao, so her first language is Papiamento, and she did not learn English from her parents. She learned it herself from YouTube and she wrote this. Super sweet. I love you so much and you are so sweet. BFF forever. Bestie forever. And that's the story is short. I hope you like it. I love you. And I like how he wrote my name. I love you. Sue-Jeen. I love how she writes my name. Oh, and I didn't show you actually. Look at my nails. They are beautiful. And the person that did them here, I'm gonna put up her name now on the screen. She is super sweet as well. Island life. Back from swimming, washing clothes. Look at this one. The one thing I miss about island life is having a yard that you can have water and do stuff outside and walk barefoot. The only thing you need missing on the Shahara is there. And my hair got so huge. I love it.
Everything she can do.
She's a good woman. A Rastafarian woman.
You like that?
Yeah. And my lovely sister are fixing the bed together. A bonding moment. Are you bonding?
No.
Why not?
Fake.
What?
You're being fake. I know.
Do you think I'm being fake? Uh-uh.
Can
uh-uh.
you slip that over?
What do you want? Sorry? This one?
Yes. How can we have one more?
This one goes in the middle there, sister. Here, sister. Thanks, sister. Say cheese. Sister changed me with a comb. She wanted to stab me today. She's being a very naughty sister. An update. I got ready yesterday to go out. I put a picture of how I looked. Stunning. And then I decided to come home. This sister is becoming a granny. Or is a granny, sorry. I'm past becoming. I am. But today, for the last day of the year, we are starting to look cute and put together. Actually, it's not put together because it doesn't always be good, but we're getting cute to go out with sister. We're gonna have lunch with the family first. Ta, sister.
I just get ready, my God.
Why do I have to get ready, sister?
Because it takes long.
What do I take long doing?
Getting makeup on.
Getting makeup. It's a vibe, sister. This sister doesn't wear no makeup at all. But this sister does. Sister. Bye, sister. One of the last outfits of 2022. And we're going golden into the new year's, guys. Golden. We're shining in the sun. Feed my soul. The last day of the year and it's raining. Ay, Dios mío. Boop. Boop. We're still going out. Oh, let's get in the car because it's raining, raining. Yeesh. And I have all these heels. Ay. But I have this for later.
Maybe Granny can give you the garbage bag.
Thanks.
Money, money, money.
They say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and bless them both in my
necker. I have crunchy fries, plantain, and red snapper. Ooh, and a fruit punch. What a beautiful view. Say cheese. Mahi mahi. Granny. Uncle. Interesca. Enough to tell you how the food was. 10 out of 10. Didn't even need sauce. Fried fish was amazing. And yours?
Very nice. Amazing.
Amazing. Oh, she all has sauce. This is the place we just ate as. Wait, what am I talking? This is the place we just ate at. It's called, I don't know, Hair doesn't have it. It says Pop's Place. And on Sebo, we also have a Pop's Place. But it's called Brisa do Mar. Breeze of the Wind.
Thank you.
best meal of 2023? How does it taste? Three in 2023. Aish. Oh, my phone fell almost. How it tastes?
Great.
How it tastes, Shai?
Hopi bone.
Hopi bone?
You take the wrong chair.
Who? Me? No. Sorry, wrong chair. Oh, orders. We're in 2023. Sorry.
2023. Woo! Health, safety, and everything else.
I'm gonna drop on my pants.
Pasta does that first, and everybody gets jealous.
What's your name?
Check.
Where it is?
A bit of tart.
By where? Sorry? What you say? Sheraska?
They have a band playing.
Playing. Where?
By Briand.
Briand playing.
Shai. What's your name, Shai?
Een beetje arroosbrouw.
Arroosbrouw, cool.
Een beetje taart, beetje champagne.
Een beetje champagne en kimas. Kimas poting.
Mayan was in rabo.
Raboku?
Bonchikara. Dumpling.
Ah, lekker.
Heel lekker.
Heb je zin in?
Een beetje
mas arroz brua. Ah, oké. Okay. Eet smakelijk. Doei, doei. We're having pastéchi. I said we're having pastéchi now for like 10 times. But okay, we're having pastéchi now. Our first snack of 2023. How late is?
4:46.
4:46, we had some Spanish breeze, some Diego music. She loved it. Say you loved it.
I hate it.
Why?
Because I don't like Spanish music.
You can't bachata?
No.
Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
Thank you, Lord. Preacher, let's
reach. Happy 1st of January. First sunset that I'm seeing of January. Oh my god, how magical is that? The water is blue. The sky is blue. The moon is out. The beach is full. Happy 1st of the month. People. I'm in my most natural form, just some gloss on, no makeup at all, and I'm going to go and have a yoni steam done by a very magical space here on Curacao at Universal Alchemist. I'm going to go to her magical sacred place here in Curacao and actually have a steam done. I do this quite often at home and haul up my own blends that I use, and I just do it in my own house, but it's my first time going out to actually have it done in a sacred space, so I'm really looking forward to it. Quite excited, a bit nervous, because we actually had to reschedule twice before, and this is now my third time and I'm going on a third, so the universe is also doing its thing, and I believe so. However, yeah, it's interesting, because when I first went there actually a few days ago, so I think it was last week we went there, I actually felt very emotional, but I held it in, which is something that I learned in therapy that I need to just let go sometime. But I was very emotional and I just let it in for a bit, so I'm a bit nervous to see what emotions will come out today. what will come up. Have my intentions down in my book. I'm just going to pick up some of my stones I have here outside charging in the rain, in the moonlight, and just getting some energy from the earth. I have my rose quartz, and I got this one from my aunt. I believe this is citrine, however it might not be, but for me it's standing for the creativity and embracing my feminine energy, which I am very much intentionally on. So yeah, a lot of things have been happening, and I feel a lot of good things happening. A lot of uncertainty, because I like to know what all these things are trying to tell me. But I'm gonna let it just unfold as it does. For now, take my crystals, other things in my bag, my journal, underwear, because to be honest with you, I'm not wearing any now. Because I just felt like, let it breathe. My sister came outside now. She's probably watching me like, why is she talking to the camera? So, but that's what I do. One day when I can actually buy her a Gucci bag, she'll realize why.
You okay?
I'm very okay. I hope you're okay. Anyway, let's go. My Yoni steam went amazingly. I feel good after doing it. Being with someone that actually is trying and helping and is able to provide me with their also healing energy and assist me in actually carrying out something so sacred and special and beautiful in her place here in Curacao feels so good. I was talking to her, like, our conversation started out on like how the past year has been, how 2022 was. I feel that 2020 was a lot more better than even 2022. 2022 just feels like what happened. The energy was quite off compared to even us being in a pandemic in 2020. The pandemic for me wasn't no issue at all. Everything went well. Or went as it should, and I didn't have a feeling to control or push anything. But yeah, and the last time, celebrating the new year of 2020, I actually was here as well. So I feel that the energy that I had then, where everything was so well, was so nice, will also be here now with me and allow me to continuously and continue my healing journey, continuing healing me, tapping into my feminine energy, taking care of my feminine and mental wellness, and also sharing it with the world. So this is just going to be a bit of a recap of what we did, everything that I can share, because of course a lot of things are so sacred, you just want to keep it at that, and are so special. But I'll give you like an overall feeling of how the experience was. Overall, it was a 10 out of 10. I made a lot of notes, because before going I actually wrote down some intentions that I had. So my first intention was to improve my womb health. Next was to assist me in releasing previous low vibrations and energies that don't uplift me, and also to get rid of any past trauma that I may have had, any past issues I'm holding on into my womb, because I do know as women we do hold a lot of our trauma and things we went through in life in our womb area. So really tapping into loosening that energy and dealing with it and healing through it. And one last one I would like to share would also be is to help me to continue to tap into my creative and feminine energy. Those are the main things, the main reasons why I went to do the Yoni steam. Some, as I mentioned, are a bit more sacred and a bit more intimate, but that was the main reason why I went.
Mosquitoes are here, so I'll probably be itching a bit.
Thankfully I went to the location before, because I think I did share when I was home that when I went previously, the energy was really high and I felt very emotional, but I didn't cry or I didn't release those emotions. But she said it's quite often that happens because her ancestors and everyone has that protected and there's enough energy around it. So that was really good to be a part of and to know that me being there was meant to be, because I also did get emotional. I also felt a lot, and I'm thankful again that I went before. So while I entered, we went into the room where I would be steaming, and then she had a bench opposite the steaming location where we just sat down and started to talk. We talked a lot about the reasons why I wanted to do my yoni steam, what my year has been like, how I feel. Being honest with each other was so good. It felt like she was a big sister that I could just talk to and say exactly how I feel without any form of judgment or negativity coming back to me. We had a conversation about my intention, which went on for a long time because I like to talk a lot and she also likes to talk. She's a really good listener and also a really good sharer. After talking and sharing, she then took out things based on my story and what I said to her on making a blend for me. She also had the water prepped about 30 minutes before so that it would not be too hot and, like, you know, just make my yoni melt away. She made that and then she told me that I would put on some music that I can listen to whenever I yoni steam also at home. I also did that when I yoni steam, just listen to some calm energy, some feminine energy healing music. On the table, she put two decks of cards that I could use if I wanted to. She put a candle, I had my music going, what else did I have? And just my notes that I made, because right before starting to steam, I made a bunch of notes of like things that popped into my head, how I felt, what I wanted to ask the cards as well. And what I wrote in my journal was at 4:04, at the Universal Alchemist, having my yoni steam done. I feel so good and able to release my emotions and feelings with Ellie. Bless her. Thank you, Myra. That's someone that reminded me of Ellie's place here in Curacao to go to. So I said thank you for her for reminding me about this place, and thank you for the universe of allowing me to come back to Curacao and be here for this. One of the things that also came up for me was fear. I have quite a lot of fear around certain things in my life, so it was good that she reminded me that I have that fear and I don't have to hold on to it. And then I pulled a card from the Oracle Goddess deck, and the first card I pulled said, "There is no need to hurry or force things to happen. Everything is occurring at perfect timing." And that was my 11:11 confirmation that I'm at the right place at the right time and everything is happening as it should. Then I steamed, I pulled my cards, I talked, and after a while she came in with a cup of tea for me, and this tea was made specially for solar plexus, which is my favorite chakra actually, the solar plexus. I drank the tea, and after I drank the tea I was crying tears of release, and I actually made a smiley face here and said thank you God, because I feel like those tears that I cried after drinking the tea, I didn't tell her this I don't think, but the tears I cried after drinking the tea made me feel safe and secure with her, which was really nice. And if you're doing a yoni steam, that's exactly what you want to have done. You want to have that feeling of feeling good where you are and what you're doing.
Hey birdie. Oh.
There's a yellow breast bird.
Come on this side. Hello. Birdie.
Oh yeah, it's magical. Overall, I would say if you're in Curacao, you want to do a yoni steam, you've never done a yoni steam, you want to have an extra spiritual, beautiful experience, check her out. I'm definitely going to put her name all over this video and also in the description box down below. You'll probably find her details also on my Instagram. And if you have any questions about it or want me to go a bit more in detail, let me know in the comments down below and I will be sure to answer you. And that is it for now. Until the next one, beautiful spirit. Bye!